Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. My name is Paul Blackmore and this is Buster's Boy Camping. Yes, you did hear that correctly. This is a channel which is now for camping. Now, for those of you who have been to the channel before, it was originally called Buster's Boy, and in that channel I talked about all things camping and photography. However, I do understand that a lot of you are interested in one subject but maybe not the other. Some of you like camping and some of you like the photography, but not necessarily both. So with that in mind, I decided to chop the channels in two. And now I have a channel, this one, Buster's Boy Camping, just for camping. And then we also have Buster's Boy Photography, which I'll put a link in here for you. Of course, if you like camping and photography, you can also follow both channels.
Cross the roundabout, second exit, A6006, Astley Road.
Now, obviously, I'm driving somewhere, and you're probably wondering where. I know. It's a place I've been to before a couple of times. Know it very well, and I am going there for camping and photography. The only problem at the moment that we've got is the weather is not going to be good, and tomorrow expecting anything up to about 50 mile an hour winds. Yeah. Right, I've got a load of driving to do. I've got a good 100 miles at least to do yet, so I shall catch you later on. lot of rain. Camping and caravanning club. Yes, I've been down this way before and it was bumpy. Ooh, here we go again. Yowls, that was loud. Yowls. Good job I brought the wellies, eh? West Runton. Oh. O-E-O-R. O-A-O-R. A-M. Bang, bang, bang. O-A-O-R. Wow. Haha! I haven't seen 5 minutes since I was here last time. Yo, meter 10. It's the Quechua. It seems like 5 minutes since I last did. A few more leaves on the trees, eh? We are done. Just gotta fill it now, obviously. Whew. Didn't take very long at all. Almost 7:45 at night. Where are I? It's almost 7:45 at night. And I did go out into Cromer to take some photos. But I went to the supermarket first. And the queues, the COVID queues, they're only, it seems like, allowing a certain amount of people in. Oh, the queues were just horrendous. And I thought, I need some refreshment. I need something to drink to quench my thirst. It was the one thing I did forget to bring. And the light in the sky, you could see it, and it just dropped like so quick, really quick. And unfortunately, I did get some photos, but filming it was a different story. And this is the trouble with YouTube, the things that people don't see behind the scenes is the fact that although your intentions are good and that you have an idea in your mind, sometimes they don't play out as you'd expect. And that was definitely the case for tonight. So, excuse me, Buster's Boy Photography, the first video is going to have to wait a little bit longer. I don't know if you can hear that right now, because I'm using the internal mic on this Insta360 1R, but it is... There, just as I said, now it's really pouring down. I was going to nip to the car and get the charger for the phone, but I'll leave it. It's fine. As I say, it's 7:45. It's been a very long day, and tomorrow may be an even longer day because of Mother Nature. So I'm going to say goodnight, and I'll hopefully see you... No, I will see you in the morning. Duh. Hopefully I'm not going home tomorrow. I'd like to keep this trip going on for a bit longer. It's only going to be a weekend one because I've got a bit of work on Monday morning. Ooh. That's rain. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to say goodnight, and I'll see you in the morning. Okay, so time for a coffee, but have you worked out which stove I'm going to be using yet? Well, this one you're familiar with, this one is the Jetboil Minimo. I absolutely love this stove. Used it a few times now and can't fault it. It's a little bit on the pricey side. And that's where this one comes in. This is called the Jetboil Zip. Now this one doesn't have an igniter like the Jetboil Minimo. It's a little bit smaller, and I wanted something that was, again, a little bit smaller than the Minimo. I wanted to try something out that was cheaper, smaller, because when I tried to go wild camping the first time, I found that there was a few issues in the fact that I was just carrying too much stuff. So I wanted to reduce the size of the products that I was taking, and this was the very first step. As much as I love the Minimo, and I do, I wanted to see if I could go a little bit smaller. So that's where this one comes into it. Now I don't remember what capacity they take because I'm not on the website at the moment, and as you can see I'm at a campsite. But that's the Minimo, and there's the Jetboil side by side, and I'll bring them a little bit closer to you. There you go, can you see that? I've got the Jetboil Zip on this side and the Minimo on this one. This one's got its built-in igniter, this one hasn't, so you've got to carry matches or a lighter with you. Other than that, they're pretty much the same, well, with the exception of the handle. The Minimo has a really nice solid handle which you can carry. This one is like a strap. They've both got neoprene covers, so that protects you from the heat, and they've both got a cup at the bottom which you can detach easily. There we are. Okay. They both have pot supports in. They both come with a burner. This one's got an igniter with it. There you go, you can see it in there. And the Minimo comes with the pot support, which allows you to put a frying pan on the top. The Zip doesn't come with that. So if you're thinking about buying the Jetboil Zip, take in consideration the fact that if you want to use a frying pan or anything like that, you have to use an additional pot stand support. Also with the Jetboil Minimo, because it's got a wider base, you can actually fit a Sea to Summit X mug in the base to protect it. Like so. Fits in there perfectly. And I use that to protect the base of the cup from the burner. Now, I'm not going to do a comparison review here. It's just to show you the basic differences. That sky is getting better and I want to go and take some photos. But I will do this when I get back home into the garden and the weather's probably a little bit more pleasing. Right, so the jet ball's it. What have I got in here? Oh wow, I've got some really good blue sky coming. Right, matches. I've got a four-class foldable spork from Decathlon. Two Taylor's coffee bags. The pot stand, or pot support. I can't remember what it's called. I'll put a name down to it below. That opens out and then goes under your fuel canister. The gas seems to be either on or off, but never not as much regulated as, say, with the burner you get on the Minimo. So I wouldn't really use this for food if I was cooking and I wanted to turn the heat down. It's more or less on, off. I'm going to fill this up to its maximum capacity. Not that I don't think I'm going to need it. And although I use the X cup as a little bit of protection at the bottom of the jet ball zip, I'm going to use the X mug. We shall see how long it takes for it to boil. That's at full capacity, which is 600 mils. That's at 600 mils. Put the lid on. There we go. Now, jet boil do suggest the fact you light the stove before you put the pot on, so that's what we're going to do. There we go. Start that timer. Meanwhile, Taylor's coffee bags, brilliant invention. Why did no one ever think about these before? Well, it's just like a tea bag, but you got none of them dreads at the bottom. Brilliant for times like this. I hope there's a clock running somewhere on this. I know I shouldn't do this, but as I say, while we wait for this to boil, I will do a full comparison review at home about the Minimo and the zip. Not bubbling yet. won't be long away. Yep, you can stop that clock now. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Now I find that the little holes in the plastic of the burner, put your fingers in them to hold, so you can turn it a lot easier. And then the spout on this is fantastic. Look at that, so precise. And I'll give that 2 minutes to brew. I'm very impressed with that. As I say, if the Minimo is a little bit, if the Minimo is a little bit out of your price range, then by all means go for the Zip. All you got to remember is the fact that you need matches or a lighter. And the fact you've got the handle. But other than that, I mean, for half the price of the Minimo, it's not bad. I'm going to enjoy that view. Thank you.
This is my second and final night. I can't camp tomorrow night because tomorrow night I've got to be at work. I've used up all my holidays this year, and all I can do is weekends. And unfortunately, in a couple of weeks' time, I was supposed to go to Windermere camping during the weekend, and that's now had to go down the Swanee because Boris Johnson has just made the announcement that we're all going to go into lockdown and places like this are going to have to close. Which is okay, that's fine. I'll postpone it or reschedule it or cancel it altogether. But today was a complete washout. The weather was just, it was blowing a gale. And if it wasn't blowing a gale, it was pouring down with rain. I got soaked through a couple of times. So yeah, the photography side didn't really happen, but that's okay, that's fine, that'll wait for another time, and it gives me another excuse to come back, doesn't it? You know, save something for another time, as they say. So yeah, I've really enjoyed it. I've loved being out and about again. It's been fantastic, and I do really, really, really love being by myself. I mean, you can tell that I am by myself because there's nobody over there, and there's nobody over there. Yeah, I'm all on my lonesome, and that's good because I kind of like that peace and quiet. It gives me time to think about the things that I'm possibly, well, it gives me time to think about the things I've left behind. It gives me time, headspace, I suppose you could call it, headspace. And I do need that, I really do. And that's what the photography used to be like. The photography used to be there as an excuse, not that I needed one, to get out and about with the camera and get a bit of me time, but the camping is an extension of that, and now I find that I don't just go out for a couple of hours, I go out for a couple of days or more, and I feel so much better for it. And that's why I love camping, absolutely love it, and I can put up with a little bit of cold. It's just the rain that bugs the hell out of me. Yeah. So yeah, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please feel free to like, comment and subscribe. I keep saying that, but I'm tired. This is going down in 1 minute's time. Yeah. We'll get through this, folks. We will. We will get through it. Until then, take care. You'll probably see me tomorrow, but it'll be like a time lapse. Me putting the car, getting everything in, just chucking it in. I just want to get home. Grand Prix on tomorrow. Take care, folks. See you soon. Stay safe.